Sairam students, welcome back to your environmental studies online class. And in environmental studies, we are going to start with our last chapter, previous chapter, which we had done in our last video. Okay, so let's begin chapter number 9, the animal world. This is the second part of video, okay? In the first part, we had read about the chapter. And now in the second part, we are going to discuss something more about this chapter and all the book work which is related to this chapter, okay? So let us begin. First, we will take an overview of the chapter one more time and then start with our book work, okay? So, in this chapter, we had read about the two things. First one is types of animals and second is uses of animals. So, what is the meaning of types of animals here? The meaning of types of animal here is that animals are of different types. Some animals live in the forest, which are called wild animals, and some animals which lives in the homes or farms, they are called the domestic animals. So basically there are two types of animals. One is wild animal and the second is domestic animals. Wild animals lives in the forest and domestic animals lives in houses or farms, okay? And the second point is uses of animals. What does that mean? It means that uses of animals means we use animals for our basic day-to-day needs and to also to earn money. For example, cow gives us milk and some people sell out the milk to earn the money and some buy the milk for their livings, for their basic livelihood needs, okay? So in this way, there are two type of animals. One is the wild animal and second is the domestic animals. And we use the animals for our different purposes also, like horses pull the carts, oxen pull the cart, and people travel through that from one place to another. So in this way we also use the animals. And similarly, we use cow for the milk, and again hen gives us, who are non-vegetarians, they eat eggs. And not for non-vegetarians, hens lays eggs and they use the eggs for their food, okay? So now see, I'm going to show you some animals. See, these are the different kinds of animals like rabbits, lion, elephant, giraffe and monkeys and butterflies, fox, deer. There are so many kinds of animals, okay? There are so many kinds of animals. And these animals are some lives in the forest and some lives in our nearby surroundings. For example, you have seen butterflies, you have seen squirrels, some of you have seen monkeys, apes, and different kind of insects. These are the common animals which you can see in your nearby surroundings. But like lion, elephant, fox, deer, giraffe, to see them we have to go to the forest or to the zoo. We cannot see these animals in our nearby surroundings, like nearby our school or nearby our house. We cannot see these animals in our nearby surroundings. So for that we have to go to the forest. So in this way there are so many kinds of animals, okay? Now see the wild animals. Now we are going to see the wild animals. Now see, this picture. In this picture, there are so many kinds of the wild animals like gorillas, elephant, and different kind of birds, or crocodile, and rhinoceros. These are all the animals which you can find in forest. Okay, now see the domestic animals. See this? These are the domestic animals which we keep at our homes, like cow, dog, horse, and hens. Okay, these are those animals which we can keep as a pet. Okay, now useful animals. See the useful animals. These are the useful animals like sheep. There is a sheep. See here, there is a sheep. Sheep gives us wool to make our winter clothes, which keeps us warm. Similarly, see here, cow. Cow gives us milk. Okay, and there is one hen. Hen lays eggs, so some of us eat eggs for the protein. Okay, so there are so many kinds of animals like piggy, like chicken, like hen, like duck. So we can these are the useful animals which we can keep as a pet. Okay, now see some more animals: duck, sheep, and piggies. Okay, some of the peoples keep piggies as their pet on their farms. Okay, now this is the overview of your chapter number 9, the animal world. Okay, so now you got it, what was in the chapter, in this chapter. Now you got that point that there are different types of animals as well as uses of animals, okay. So let us begin to do our book work. Okay, see in your books, your first activity of the book is tick the correct word. You just have to tick the correct word. Okay, so the first is, we get fruits, milk, eggs from hen. So what do you get from hens? We get fruits from hens. Does hens give fruits? No. We get fruit from plants. So this is not a correct option. So the next, milk. Does hen give milk? No. Cow gives milk. This is correct. Cow gives milk. Now see, eggs. Does hen give eggs? Yes, hen gives egg. So tick on eggs. Now see the second one. We get curd, milk, or tea from cows. Do you get curd from cow? No, we can make the curd from milk. We do not get curd from the cows. Second is milk. Does you get milk from the cows? Yes, we get milk from the cows. So tick on milk. Now the third is, we get honey, eggs, wool from sheep. So do you get honey from the sheep? No, we get honey from honeybee. So this is the wrong option. Do you get eggs from the sheep? No, we do not get eggs from the sheep. Hen lays egg. So this is also the incorrect option. So does you get wool from the sheep? Yes, sheep give us wool. Tick on wool.
Sheep gives us wool to keep us warm in the winter. Now the fourth. Oxen help to pull carts, engines, cars. Does oxen help to pull the carts? Yes, oxen help us to pull the carts to keep the things and the people from one place to another. Okay, now the next options, engines and the car, are wrong, because train have the engines, not oxen. Similarly, cars doesn't have oxen, they have engines. Okay, fifth is, wild animals live in the house, forest, park. Does wild animals lives in the house? No. If wild animals lives in the house, they will eat you. So this is the wrong option. Second is forest. Does wild animals lives in the forest? Yes, they lives in the forest. So tick on the forest and cut out the park, because wild animals doesn't live in the park. Okay, one more time, I am going to show you only the tick options. We get eggs from the hens. So tick on eggs. Second is, we get milk from the cows. Third is, we get honey. We get dash from the sheep. We get wool from the sheep. Next is, oxen helps to pull carts. Stick on carts. Fifth is, wild animals live in the forest. Stick on the forest. So this is your book activity. Now see the another activity from your book. See here. Look at these animals carefully. Some of them are wild animals. Some can be kept in farms or at homes. Put them in the right column. One has been done for you. Okay, so see in your books, there are the picture of animals like this. What you have to do? You have to just circle out the wild animals and as well as circle out the domestic animals. Okay, there are some of the wild animals and some of the farm or the animals which you can kept at your home. Okay, so just you have to circle out and write down the below. Write down the name of them in the below columns. See the first is horse. Horse is a wild animal or a domestic animal? Horse is a domestic animal. Next is goat. Goat is a wild animal or a domestic animal? Goat is a domestic animal. Next is giraffe. Giraffe is a wild animal or a domestic animal? It is wild animal. Next is elephant. Does elephant is a wild animal? Yes. Next is deer. Deer is a domestic animal or a wild animal? Does deer is a domestic animal? No, it is a wild animal. Similarly, next is bear. See, one more time, this is the domestic animal. Goat is a domestic animal. And okay, so this is the first is domestic animal, second is domestic animal, giraffe is a wild animal, elephant is a wild animal, deer is a wild animal, bear. What it is? Bear is a wild animal. Donkey is a domestic animal. Zebra is a wild animal. Next is squirrel. Squirrel is a domestic animal? No, it is also a wild animal. You can see the squirrels in forest usually. Then sheep. Sheep is a domestic animal. Rhinoceros. Rhinoceros is a wild animal. Rabbit. Rabbit is also a wild animal. But sometimes some people keep rabbits as their pets. And next is parrot. Parrot is a domestic animal. Next is a monkey. Monkey is also a wild animal. Then rooster. Rooster is a domestic animal. Then cow. Cow is a domestic animal. And cat is also a domestic animal. Okay. So in the below column, you just have to write the name accordingly. I'm going to show you. See here, like in this column which I have told you, you have to write like this, see in the zoo or the forest. So write accordingly, like in the zoo, in the forest, write down as it is written giraffe, which is wild. So you have to write in it the zoo or the forest. Elephant in the zoo and the forest, and write deer in the zoo and the forest, bear in the zoo and the forest. Yeah, in this way, in this columns. Okay, zebra and squirrel, rhinoceros, rabbit, monkey. That's it. And the remaining ones are domestic: horse, goat, donkey, sheep, rooster, cat and cow. Write down these in the home or the farm animal. Okay, so write this in your book of EST. Okay, now see the next, your next activity is you just have to join the dots. You just have to join the dots and complete the pictures. Then you have to color these pictures. Like the first one is of cow. You have to join these numbers 1, 2, 3 and 4. And then your cow is complete. Now you have to color these animals. Next is like horse. You just have to add the numbers like this. Similarly in the piggies, you just have to join the numbers like this. And now you just have to color this whole picture. You just have to color this whole picture. Okay. So now see, life skills and values. Here are the life skills and the values. So learning to be compassionate towards animals, learning to be compassionate towards animal, developing critical thinking skills. So here is this activity about your thinking skills and your values and your legacies. Okay, now see this. First is, which of these children are being cruel to animals? Discuss in class. You just have to see, read these, and you just have to know that which of these children are cruel to animals and which of these children are kind to the animals. See the first one. First, Hema takes her dog for a walk every day. Does it is a cruelty to take your dog at walks? No, it is a good thing. So it is a good thing. Hema takes her dog for the walk every day. Okay, now see the second one. Vikas throws stones at the cow to chase them away. Do you think that throwing the stones on the animals like cows or the dogs is a good thing? No, it is very, very bad. You never do this because animals also have skins and muscles. They also got hurt from these. So you never do this. Never throw the stones on the animals. So this is a wrong thing. Vikas is not a good boy. He is a bad boy. See the next one, third one. Shreya loves to tease the monkeys that come to her colony. So it is a good thing to tease the monkey? No, it is very bad thing to tease any of the animal. So this is also a very bad thing. Shreya is a bad child. We do not tease the animals ever, cause they also have heart, they also have skin, they also got hurt. Okay, so never do this, otherwise they will bite you. Now see the fourth one. Dino keeps a bowl of seeds and water outside his house. for the birds in the summer. This is a good thing to keep the water in the summers outside for the birds. Yes, it is a very good thing to keep the water in the summers for birds, because they do not got water everywhere in the summers, because everything got dry in the summers. So that for that reason you just have to put some of the water in a bowl, and with water put some rice also on your top roof of your house, so that the birds can eat and drink water. This is a very good thing for everyone, and you just have to do this. Make it as your habit. In the early morning you just have to go at your roofs and put some grains and water for the birdies. Okay, now see the next one. Even is Tara keeps her car locked. Tara keeps her cat locked in her room. So does it a good thing that you have to keep lock your pets in room? No, that is very bad thing, cause pets also have lives in it. So that's why you do not have to keep any of the pet in your room locked. So that is why if you do not care for them, you do not love them, don't keep pets. If you have pets, love them, show care for them, because they are so sweet. If you love them, they will also love you. They never hurt you. Okay, so don't keep. This is also a bad thing. Tara is also a bad girl. Do not never lock any of the pet in any rooms, or never do misbehave with the animals. Okay, now see the next is, next question related to this is, look at this picture A and B carefully. Which would be better place for animals and the plants to live in? Can you explain this to your teacher? Can you explain this to your teacher? Yes, the first place where all the animals is, it is a good place, picture A, or picture B is a good place for the animals? The place where no trees, smoke and bad streets, bad food, no good food, no good environment is present, is that a good place for the animals? In the first picture, does it a good place? No, it is not good. Why? Because animals lives in the very good environment, very fresh environment, where all over the trees, which is all over covered with the trees, there is a shed for them, water for drinking, clean water, clean air, then only they can survive for a long time. Okay, so the first picture is not good. See the second picture, there is all over the greenery, river, water, and a very good and a happiness place. So this is a picture B, is a true picture to keep the animals, because they cannot survive in the bad places. So this is your book work. This is all about your book work. You have to do this work in your books. Thank you so much. Stay well at your homes and stay safe.